folks that have seen the show just had an opportunity to check it out. All right, well, we'll give you the link afterwards. It's a long one, but you definitely should check it out. It's good, amazing documentary, actually. So we have the producer of the documentary here on hand. We're going to talk to Shan. Shan's from the channel News Asia. Do you want to come on over and we'll see if we can plant ourselves on these things? Do a quick Q&A. All right, so how did you work to start? I mean, this was maybe give a little bit more background in terms of the documentary and where its roots came from.
Sure. Even thank you, Jim, for letting me be here. 6 months, I think about 8 months ago, I had zero knowledge about VR. So I was doing a project in Rwanda, I got back to my company, and my boss said, you're doing a project on VR. I said, okay, what is that about? I started doing research, and the first place I found locally, you know, there's a lot of content in the US and UK and stuff, but the first thing I found was Asia VR. So this is the first place that I came, and I networked, and I found people. And from there, I took a quick course, 4 month course on Unity and Unreal Engine. Then my challenge was to create 4 VR and 5 VR content based on a topic called Challenge Tomorrow. So the topics were climate change, aging population, cybersecurity, future work, future technology. Future work and tech combined into one. So they wanted to create public awareness, so create a content to promote this series Challenge Tomorrow. So I said, who's going to do this? I said, this is going to find people to do this. Budget? As usual, you know, access people has never budget. So I went up and I said, while you're doing that, just do a documentary of the making of. And I said, making of? Plus the making of? Okay, so I went out looking for people to create VR, and you know, we did the budget, scope ahead. Plus I created a story around this documentary. And I realized that the young people, the institutes, the polytechnics, that's where I got 3 of the projects was done by Nanyang Polytechnic, Masik Polytechnic, Regis Institute. Most of VR was at least 64 meters. So I got all these 4 people on board the project. For climate change, I did something like we recreated Poco waterway and brought it to 100 years. And how climate change affected the disruption that it caused. For aging, we chose dementia and shot a 360 video with animations and graphics to show the discomfort that a dementia patient goes through. And for cybersecurity, we wanted, my boss wanted something lighthearted, so I created a day gone wrong situation. An ex-boyfriend hacks a restaurant and everything goes wrong with graphics going in. The final one was future work and tech. That's even close to what you guys are showing. But on a basic level, how Tomasic Poly created, which is HTC Hive, how a developer works, you know, when you buy a PTO, you can go in, you can choose the amenities, you know, and when you do the changes to your flow and statistics, how big data goes into doing changes on the ground. So we created that and I filmed the whole process.
Now, how did you arrive at these 4 sort of sections or topics? How did you actually choose those?
Yeah, it's a back and forth, you know, for aging, I had to look through their content, I found out dementia is something that needs a bit more awareness, and you know, we have a dementia campaign, there's a dementia neighborhood, and so we spoke to some of the hospitals, and they were supporting us, and they gave us the expertise to dementia patients, and so we created the tunnel vision and all those stuff.
So overall, with your team, how big was it? It was 4 big productions, plus the making of and making up.
Three people. Yeah, but we get the usual things probably at the master 40, so we get a few people just building
the project teams around. What do you define the biggest challenge?
Post production and bugs. There's always bugs. Because you know there's an age to deliver and we wanted to bring it because the show is going on there on 26, 28. So a few weeks before I had to bring it to the speech to the people to experience it. Always bugs. There's always something to get better, but we have to do bigger and then we do the least productive. But what is the latency? se riuniti con il conoscitore e non la discoteca e la loro attenzione.
So what kind of equipment were you using to do all this? You mentioned Unreal.
Unreal, one in Unity, one in Shop 360, like 8 cams, 6 cameras, we have animation, the whole thing that stuff.
In camera wise?
Last thing I think before we close up, we're always looking for creators who are doing very nice. happened, it was very few. So it's guys who are going out there creating content and stuff like that, please let me know. At least when you have some project coming up, it will be the first week to make contact and information.
It's an easy search, just click on toggle from real to real. And you'll be able to find it. Ashima, do you want to do some announcements?
Yes.
We're going to wrap it up here.
Yes, I'm coming.